In this video, I'll be going over the top 5 roller coasters that could be leaving Cedar Point in the future. What is up, y'all? This is your boy, Mystic Timbers Fanboy, coming in with a new video as always. So in this video, I'll be going over the top 5 roller coasters that could be leaving Cedar Point in the future. But before we get into that video, so you guys understand. So Cedar Fair has been removing rides that have lost popularity and rides that are hard to maintain. For example, like the Orbiter, which was at Canada's Wonderland, the Crypt, which is recently closed, and Volcano, the Blast Coaster, are the top 3 examples of roller coasters that have lost popularity or are maintenance issues. Now, I'm going to go over the roller coasters that could be removed in the future at Cedar Point. Starting off at number 5 is Gemini. So there are rumors of Gemini. Some people think Gemini could be leaving in the future, which is true, but it's not going to be leaving that quick. So Gemini is a aerodynamics racing hybrid coaster. This ride is really smooth. It is a kick-ass ride. I would be sad if Gemini left, but some people think Gemini could be leaving because Cedar Point might be getting a dueling inverting GCI concept that GCI is working on right now, but I think Gemini is staying. It's not going anywhere. So that's just my opinion. It's not happening. At number 4 is Cedar Creek Mine Ride. So Cedar Creek Mine Ride is a aero mine train. There's really nothing special to this ride. The only thing really special about this ride is that it's Cedar Point's second oldest roller coaster. And in my opinion, Cedar Creek Mine Ride is forceless and it's rough. Cedar Creek Mine Ride is too rough and too forceless for an aero mine train, to be honest. Even Adventure Express wasn't that bad. But Cedar Creek Mine Ride, I would not care if it left or if it even leaves Cedar Point. Anything better could replace Cedar Creek Mine Ride. For example, maybe like a Gerslau or Eurofighter. Maybe they could replace Cedar Creek Mine Ride with a Vekoma Family Coaster or a small kitty gravity group wooden coaster like Kentucky Flyer. This ride, I would not care if it goes, in my opinion. I would not be sad. Like, I really would not care if this ride left. So, that's just my opinion. Next one is Corkscrew at Cedar Point. So, Corkscrew is an aerodynamics custom looping coaster. It was the world's first roller coaster to have 3 inversions. The ride experience on Corkscrew is not that good. I mean, Corkscrew is too short of a ride. It has a terrible layout. The only good thing about Corkscrew is the little ejector airtime hill and the 2 corkscrews. Everything else sucks. I know some people will say Corkscrew's not going to leave because it was the world's first roller coaster to have 3 inversions. Well, I'll give you an example. Vortex was the world's first roller coaster to have 6 inversions, and a lot of people didn't think that would leave, but Cedar Fair didn't mind or didn't care about tearing down Vortex and its station. So if Cedar Fair didn't care about tearing down Vortex, even though it was the world's first roller coaster to have 6 inversions, why wouldn't they care about tearing down Corkscrew in the future? And I do not know what they would replace this roller coaster with. It would be a really hard decision. The second roller coaster on his list that is more likely to leave is Iron Dragon at Cedar Point. So Iron Dragon is Cedar Point's aero suspended coaster. It is the most tamest out of the rest of the aero suspended coasters that Aerodynamics has made. At first, when I rode Iron Dragon, I really didn't like it because it was forceless. But in 2018, but when I rode it in 2019, I liked Iron Dragon more. I believe it was because Iron Dragon got new wheels and they kind of upgraded the trains a little bit. So the reason I think Iron Dragon is most likely to leave is because of maintenance issues. We know that Aero suspended coasters have a lot of maintenance issues because Aero went bankrupt in 02 because of X2. So Iron Dragon is down all the time. It's down most of the time. When I first went to Cedar Point in 2018, I wanted to ride Iron Dragon. That would have been my fourth ride. But because Iron Dragon was closed and it had a lot of maintenance issues, and the maintenance crew and the ride operators were working out, so that's why I wasn't able to ride it until like a few hours later. That's when they finally started to get Iron Dragon opened. In 2019, when I came back to Cedar Point, after riding Rougarou and getting all my new coaster credits, I decided to go back and try and ride Iron Dragon. But unfortunately, I was standing there for like, let's say 25 minutes and stuff. The ride operator said, "Sorry for your inconvenience, Iron Dragon is down due to maintenance issues." So I believe this ride is leaving because Iron Dragon, it's not reliable. Even though it is a good family coaster, this ride, it's not reliable compared to other coasters in the park. And that will be Iron Dragon's main downfall. I believe Iron Dragon will probably not be still operating after 6 or 7 years. That's when the ride is going to leave. The number one coaster like on this list that is likely going to be removed is Wicked Twister. So Wicked Twister is Cedar Point's Intamin Impulse coaster. I believe Wicked Twister will not get the X, unlike the other coasters on this list that I have mentioned. Wicked Twister is more likely to get relocated to another park. For example, like California's Great America, because there was rumors about Wicked Twister leaving Cedar Point and that it could be going to California's Great America, because California's Great America is supposed to get a impulse coaster that goes over 200 feet, I believe. That's what it was. And Wicked Twister is probably that coaster that goes over 200 feet. So, yeah, so I believe Wicked Twister has a fighting chance, and I don't believe it's going to get scrapped like the other coasters I've mentioned, like I said. So I kind of would be sad to see Wicked Twister go, but at least it'll be in California instead of being in the junkyard. So make sure you guys like and subscribe. See you later. Bye.